Today is International Women's Day, and you are the chairperson of the Committee on Women, Children, and Families in the Senate. Let's talk about some, accomplishments in terms of women in the Philippines. Okay, let's talk about that. In 1993, okay, you were responsible for women being granted the right to become cadets in the Philippine Military Academy through Republic Act 7192, or Women in the Development and Nation Building Act. And I know you had a speech recently. So let's talk about these accomplishments, you know, women moving forward in the Philippines.
Well, the Women in Development and Nation Building Act was a beautiful law led by former Senator Santanina Rasul, and beautifully in collaboration with former Senator Raul Rocco. So demonstrating, Karen, how great things are possible and ideally possible when women and men, and of whatever soji I could add today, work together hand in hand to build our nation. Iyang Republic Act 7192 was a recognition, Karen, of, yes, the long way we women had come even then, but also remained a challenge to us until today na malayo pa ang ating lalakarin, matagal-tagal pa ang laban. Today, we have women, for example, in all branches of government, at all levels of government, but best represented to maybe 30-35% at the local government unit level. Lumiliit yung percentage na yan, Karen, as we ascend the levels of government to the House, to the Senate, and across the branches of government. Sa Senate nga, higit isang daan taon na kami, pero we've had only, can you believe, more than 20 women senators, at ni isa ay wala pang nakapagsilbi bilang Senate President. When you look at the private sector, of course, we women are so strongly represented in the rank and file, more and more so over time at the mid-level, pero kulang pa sa level ng mga presidents at CEOs, for example, ng mga kumpanya. And in civil society, it also remains a struggle, believe it or not, to advance women's rights and feminism, kahit pa sa masasabi nating pinaka-progresibong bahagi na ng ating lipunan. We also always do well tayo sa Pilipinas in, for example, the Global Gender Gap Index. And yet, ang dami pa rin gaps that we have to fill. So it means that we're still alive, Karen, at an interesting time na ang dami pang mabuti at importante kailangan gawin. And in addition to what we celebrate today, ibig sabihin we also recommit ourselves to that lifelong task of advancing not just ourselves but all our sisters, lalo na yung mga susunod pa atin, our daughters.
Okay, and let's not forget the solo. This actually has your signature on it, so to speak. This was a main advocacy that you fought for, the expanded solo Parents Welfare Act. Well, technically, it both is for men and women.
Yes.
We know that in the Philippines, of course, you have many single mothers who struggle, right, raising the children on their own. So let's talk about this right now, how this law has actually helped many single mothers today.
Okay. Well, a lot of solo moms and yes, solo dads too, in their solo parent organizations and federations really worked on crafting and passing this into law. Kaya lahat kami nagdiwang ng sama-sama when it was passed into law, Karen. Marami-raming dagdag na benepisyo sa batas na ito, which solo moms and dads now can enjoy and are beginning to enjoy a 1,000 pesos monthly subsidy or ayuda for solo parents earning minimum wage and less, discounts on certain necessary daily needs of children of solo parents of a certain yearly income below up to 6 years of age of their children, scholarships for children of solo parents and even qualified solo parents from DepEd, CHED, and TESDA. Priority in government housing for solo parents, automatic membership of solo parents in PhilHealth. At ang lahat ng ito, Karen, na pwedeng pakinabangan ng solo parents, not only until the kids are 18 years of age, pero dahil nga ipinasa natin earlier yung K-12 law, until the children are 22 years of age, because that's the age lamang at which the children start graduating.
All right. How would you describe the Philippines in terms of women's advancements? Now, clearly, recent studies have come out saying 81% of Filipinas feel that there are fair opportunities at work. They can go professionally. It's much higher than the feelings or sentiments of other women in Asia. We've had two women presidents in the Philippines. And yet the irony, we don't have divorce. And the RH law was the hardest to fight for, which would have, which gives women, right? I mean, easy access to contraception, to take control of their bodies, to actually time their pregnancies. Where are we with the implementation of the RH law, which is actually a very pro-women law? Yung totoo po, on the ground.
Yes.
How is it on the ground?
Well, on the ground, tama ka, Karen, after 14 years of fighting for that bill to be passed into law, plus one more year in the Supreme Court dahil in-assail yung constitutionality ng batas, pero eventually in-uphold ng Supreme Court na hindi ito unconstitutional, ito ay constitutional. You're right, until today, kailangan mag-oversee ang Kongreso that it is fully and properly implemented. Taon-taon, kailangan naming bantayan na fully funded ang item na ito sa Department of Health o sa buong health system. At maya't-maya, ang mga RH law advocates kailangang ilaban that it be implemented, for example, in a particular local government unit kung saan maaaring umayaw ang isang LGU official. Dahil sa personal beliefs nila. Pero kailangan naming i-assert, sir, ma'am, batas po ito ng buong republika. Kailangan ipatupad hanggang sa bawat LGU. So this is one area, Karen, that shows na malayo man ang narating natin, malayo pa ang ating lalakbayin. Implementasyon ng RH law and, as you mentioned, yung deliberasyon at harinawang pagpasa ng Dissolution of Marriage Bill, which just as the RH law is pro-women, pro-youth, pro-family, sinasabi din ng advocates ng Dissolution of Marriage Bill, women and men alike, ha, Karen, na the Dissolution of Marriage or Divorce Bill is pro-marriage, pro-family, pro-women, men as well, and pro-children.
All right. On that note, Senator Risa Ontiveros, thank you so much for joining me.
Salamat.
Happy International Women's Day.
Happy International Women's Day.